Rabbi Shahrisadri Sirlemri, Wakhlub the Tamilisanya Kahu Kavli. Assalamu alaikum. Today I'm going to talk about two names of Allah again, because as I mentioned before, some of the names are mentioned always together to keep a perfect balance. The two names I'm going to talk about today are Al Hafid, and Ar Rafi. They're roughly translated as Al-Hafid as the reducer, the abaser, and Ar-Rafi as the exalter, the elevator. As we can see, they are quite opposite, but that's why they are always mentioned together, because we have to remember that Allah is the one who can elevate us and who can abase us, both in this world and the hereafter. But the criteria for Allah to elevate someone in this life is, of course, very different from the criteria he has for the elevation of people in the next life. Because in the afterlife, Allah will only elevate the people who followed his path and who were righteous, and will abase the people that were rejecting what he sent through the prophets and his books. Whereas here, Allah can elevate anybody, just about anybody, really. And we can see that from the Quran and from the world around us. As we can see from the Quran, he elevated Pharaoh, for example, to such an extent that he was ruling and he was one of the biggest rulers in the world at his time, subhanallah. And he was even claiming to be God or equal to God, astaghfirullah. So Allah can really elevate just about anyone. And they don't need to even put any effort into it. As we know, many royals are born into a family and they just inherit the title or the position of their forefathers and so on. So really, it doesn't depend on the actions of the people or what they do or what are their intentions when it comes to elevation in this world. Allah may elevate anybody for different reasons. Some of them might be to even trial them, to test them, and to even punish them, to see how they will behave having this power. But how can we use these two names in our everyday life? As we can see, Allah is the one who can elevate and abase. But sometimes Allah gives us similar power as well. And that is when we have wealth or influence. We can influence the decision of people in order to choose or appoint someone to a higher position, or to abase someone depending on what our will is, for example. So let's say that we want someone to win an election or whatever, and we have a lot of wealth and a lot of influence, and we use it to get this person into power. And we know that this person is not a good person and is not looking out for the people and so on. So Allah is testing us through this as well. And we can do the opposite as well. We can abase someone who is doing their job and who is doing their best, but still we can put them down. So if we do have this influence, this kind of influence, or even if it's a small influence about small decisions and small positions, it doesn't matter. Even if it is just about the normal everyday life and about the honor of a person, let's try to always elevate the people that we think deserve it and that will serve the ummah and the people around them, and not try to put them down. Let's try to help them to go up and do the best that they can. And it goes the same for us. Let's always strive to do our best, inshallah. And also, when we ask Allah for elevation, let ask him for elevation in this world, but in the hereafter most of all. And in a hadith, it is said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the person who humbles themselves in front of Allah, Allah will raise them. And Allah will raise them, inshallah, in this world and in the hereafter as well. So let always ask about that. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.